हेलो, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। टुडे संडे, सो आई एम लिटिल बिट कैजुअल, बट जस्ट आई वाज फ्री एंड आई डिसाइडेड टू शेयर समथिंग बिकॉज इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग व्हिच हैज हैपेंड विथ वन केस एंड आई वांट टू शेयर दैट केस अलोंग विथ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द रेमेडी। So it was stuck to my mind. I immediately come over here and I want to share something which is very important and from which you can learn a lot. It was a case long time back. She's a lady who came to me for the psoriasis. So I have started the case. I have taken all the details, everything, and after some time she has shown me one prescription, and it was a prescription of a gynecologist. So I asked her for what purpose she went to the gynecologist, and she said it's only because I had a very severe leukorrhea, and it was off and on I was getting. So I have shown gynecologist, she examined me, she have done the parvaginal examination, scopy, and she said that there are some erosions on the cervical, on the cervix, and because of which I am having this problem. And she asked me to go for the cautery, but I never, because I was frightened. And I took her whatever the medicine she has given. It was a little bit better, but I am getting that off and on. And she, in fact, during the whole story, actually, I have not got all those things. So I searched what may be the remedy which is having a very close relationship between the female genital complaints, a cervical erosion, along with the psoriasis. So I was thinking, and I got the remedy. Yes, definitely it is there, and that is the Kali Arsenicum. So I have given Kali Arsenicum to that lady. I have started with her 30 potency. I have repeated it for 2 to 3 days, and thereafter she has kept on placebo and along with the biocombination number 13, the leukorrhea. And to my surprise, after 15 days, when she returned, then she was having a very good result. Her itching was completely stopped. Eruptions were there. But basically, her leukorrhea recovered very fast. It worked so fast that she said that within 2-3 days, there was no discharge per vagina, and I was feeling very good. And I have treated for a period of nearly about 1 year, and she recovered from both the things, from the psoriasis along with leukorrhea, which never recurred thereafter. I have changed the potencies, the Kali Arsenicum, whenever the patient slips back into the psoriatic problems again and again. So I have changed the potency to 200, then later on 1 mL. Those potencies I have used. And she recovered completely thereafter with the psoriasis. But she was continued for treatment nearly about 4 years to show me every year. Because every winter she used to get little bit affection. But she used to get she used to recover very fast with the help of the remedy. So why not to share this from the Boric suspect? And why not to learn the Kali Ars from the Boric suspect? That's what a thought in my mind. So let us share, let us discuss about what Boric says about the Kali Arsenicum, so that we can learn by heart. So what he says, the Kali Ars patient tends towards malignancy and invertebrate skin disease. Skin malignancy, this is one of the important remedy. Invertebrate skin disease, the difficult skin disorders like psoriasis, like lichen planus, like eczema, these are the disorders which from which patient suffers from longer time of duration and which never recovers. So this is very important thing which he is explaining, and in the first sentence only. And never forget this first sentence of a Boric, because he gives the essence of that in the first sentence only. This is a very perfect word which he has used, that invertebrate skin diseases. Yes. Whenever you are not getting result, think of Kaliyarsenicosum in skin entities which are not getting settled. What he says, he is restless, nervous and anemic. That restlessness might be because of the arsenic element which is there along with it. Then person is quite nervous on the tip of their nerve. That irritability is of the arsenic again. And third important thing, the anemia is there associated. So this is very typical presentation. In the first two sentences, he gives directly a picture in front of your mind that patient who is suffering from the invertebrate skin disorder, along with restlessness, along with nervousness, along with anemia, this is the one important remedy. And then he explains in short about the skin conditions first. So let us see what he says, and we'll learn every sentence of this. Intolerable itching whenever the person is undressing, and this was there in that specifically in that lady, that whenever she used to remove her clothes for changing, her itching used to get increased. And this is very typical feature. Kaliyarsenicosum it is having it, even in Thuja you have the same symptom. But this is very typical. Whenever the patient tries to change their clothes, the itching increases. This is quite common with the fungus also. The fungal infection, in general, whenever a person is covered, the fungal infection is little bit settled. But as soon as he tries to change or remove, and then the itching increases. So think about it in such types of diseases, because fungus nowadays, it is very, very marked. Or in fact, it becomes an invertebrate skin disease also. What is this? Dry, scaly and wilted. This is very important. The eruptions which are dry, they are scaly. The eruptions generally in psoriasis, they are easily detachable scales which are there. They are silvery white scales in psoriasis. In cases of lichen planus, the scale is there, but scale is not easily detachable. It is fixed and it is not so severe, which happens to be there in psoriasis. But in both those types of skin eruptions, acne. What type of acne? Acne which are pustules, worse during menses. So pustular acne specifically during menses. Whenever menses has to happen, the pustules comes on the face. See, this is the thing which you have to understand. You correlate it. The remedy, you always keep it in your mind by understanding those sentences. So pustular acne, which are different varieties of eruptions. The eruptions are basically of four types. First is macule, the second is papule, the third is vesicle, fourth is pustule. What is a macule? Any skin eruption which is not raised above the skin surface but altered in color is called as a macule. Then second is papule. Any skin eruption which is raised above the skin surface but less than 0.5 cm of a diameter is called as a papule. Third is any papule which contains fluid is called as a vesicle. So any skin eruption which contains fluid and which is having less than 0.5 cm of diameter is called as a vesicle. And fourth variety, any papule which contains pus is pustule. So these pustular acnes are generally papular, but sometimes they are pustular. So pustular variety of acne is covered over there and it has typical modality. It happens to be there in the specifically during menses. Then what he says? There is chronic eczema, itching worse from warmth, walking and undressing. What is an eczema? Generally what happens, we never consider what is the skin condition. We never learn it by heart. Eczema in Marathi, it is called as gachkarn. Or in another word for eczema is dermatitis. First, understand the definition. Definition is very clear and then you will understand the depth of eczema. Eczema is a skin disorder, a cyclical pattern of disorder. Cyclical, this is very important word, where it starts with the papule. Papule leads towards the vesicle. Vesicle ruptures over after scratching and ulcer develops. Ulcer heals with lichenification. Lichenification means thickening of the skin. And after unlichenified area, again a papule develops. this cyclical pattern goes again and again and continues is called as the eczema. So this is a vicious circle. It goes and goes and goes on. There is no treatment to break this vicious circle in allopathy. That's why they used to apply only local ointments. Till you go on applying the steroids locally, eczema is suppressed whenever, or it's palliated whenever the star stops, it recurs, or if it's suppressed, it produces some pathology over there. And that's why they don't have any specific permanent treatment for eczema. But we have ample remedies to treat the eczema. Like Kaliyarsan Kosam, there are n number of remedies. My suggestion to all of you is that eczema is not a superficial skin entity. It has a big background in it. And that's why eczema is generally hereditary tendency. So whenever such types of, whenever eczemas are there, psoriasis are there, lichen planus are there, which are not superficial skin entities, always utilize the potency little bit medium or higher. Don't use the low potency because it never yields to low potency very easily, even though the remedy is right. So that is my practical suggestion to all of you, because this is what I experience with number of patients. So what he says about the eczema, chronic eczema, itching worse from warmth. So whenever there is heat, whenever patient lies on bed is warm and patient gets very much severe itching. The itching aggravates whenever he used to lie down on the bed. From walking produces a heat. Again, itching develops. Undressing, removing the clothes, the itching develops. These are the characteristics, whether it is psoriasis, whether it is eczema, whether it is lichen planus, whether it is any malignant skin condition, but modalities defines you the remedy. So modalities are very essential. What he says further, psoriasis, lichen. So he has himself given, it is a remedy for psoriasis in italics, also for lichen. Pagadenic ulcers. Pagadenic means spreading ulcers. The ulcers which are spreading continuously. Fissures in the bends of the arms and knees. Where it affects the bends of arms, bends of knees, the folds, folded area, the eruptions are there. That again we get generally in cases of fungus, in cases of lichen planus, very commonly. Gouty nodosities. See, this remedy covers that gout also. So uric acid diathesis is also one of the important entity which is there and which produces a nodosities. Think of Kali arsenicosis. In fact, these nodosities itself suggests or explains that this remedy is having the psychotic element also along with the syphilitic. So it is not only syphilitic, it is psychosyphilitic remedy, generally goes in favor of the tubercular miasm. Gouty nodosities worse when there is a change of weather. Skin cancer, where suddenly an alarming malignancy without any external signs sets in. Skin malignancy, generally rare, but whenever skin malignancy is there, this chemo bemo, it doesn't work. Radiation never works. These are the common treatments which are there. They never work. The primary source, primary focus is in skin. It is very difficult to tackle. Homeopathy has many remedies. And one of the remedy, one should not forget is Kaliyas, where you, if you match the typical modalities and a typical sensation or a itching, if it meets properly, think of Kaliyars and give the Kaliyars. Kaliyars will bring that patient out. This is very important. Whenever any pathology is mentioned under the remedy, learn that pathology also. Understand that pathology. Correlate it. So every eczema you must know by heart. You must know what is psoriasis. You must know what is lichen planus. You must know skin malignancy. If you understand them as a disease, then you can apply your remedy properly in such types of cases. Last sentence which he says over there, numerous small nodules under the skin. These are the nodules which are generally as a secondaries or as the primaries which happens to be there in skin malignancy, as well as sometimes it might be a gouty nodosities. It is variable, but for both purposes, you must think about the Kaliyarsan Kosam. So this is a very specific remedy or on for the skin elements, and then he has explained the female complaints, and you find it out the cauliflower like excrescences on of the os uteri with the plying pins, foul smelling discharge and pressure below the pubis. Cauliflower like excrescences, cervical erosions, generally these are the psychotics, these are gonorrhea more commonly. If they are there associated with the skin element, think of this remedy first. Where there is a patient complaint, there is a pain in lower abdomen, patient complaint, there is a very foul smelling discharge, patient complaint, there is the itching along with that in the vaginal area. These are very difficult features of the Kali arsenicosum, and patient becomes too much restless. The arsenic restlessness comes out along with whenever it is associated with Kali. And that's why that restlessness disturbs the patient a lot, and patient comes to you with such a feature. So this is a remedy one should not forget. This is a remedy one must think whenever the psoriatic patients are there or eczematous patients are there. And what he says, relationship is radium. Yes, radium brome I used to use number of times whenever there are the x-ray burns. This is good remedy to be used in such types of cases. Radium bromatum I am using in rheumatic cases and skin condition. Radium brome is a very important close remedy to this, where you can get the skin malignancies, where you can get the psoriatic eruptions, where you can get the eczematous eruptions, and they are very close to each other. Only thing is that they differ at the modalities level. Radium brome is again a deep acting remedy because bromatum comes along with in that because it has a radiating focus. The radiation used to produce a very strong affections on the body, and that's why radium brome is one remedy which he has mentioned along with this to compare over there. And what he says regarding the dose, that 3 to 30th potency. I have used it in 6, I have used in 12C, I have used in 30, even 200, 1M. These potencies I used to keep with myself, and I'm using that with very good success, depending upon the patient's susceptibility, patient's requirement, depending upon the pathology. But it works a lot. So never forget the Kali arsenicosum whenever the female complaints associated with the skin pathologies, where you get the psoriasis, you get the lichen planus, you get the eczematous eruption with a typical leucorrhea or a cauliflower like growth on cervix. Never forget Kali ars. So that's the thing which I want to share with you all of you, because it is a very useful in practice. I learned a lot about this in my practice, and that's why I want to share this with you. Thank you very much for there, and go share all those practical hints because it helps in practice. So thank you very much. We'll meet again.